way we met was that I was driving home from work, and I saw some poor sap broke down on the side of the road with his motorcycle, and I happen to fix motorcycles, and I drove him home, and he hasn't left me alone since. This is Taya. I was friends with her mom, and her mom went through some rough times. So we got Taya. Her mom's getting on her feet, so we're gonna have her now that we're back in town.
When we moved to Michigan, we were homeless. Right off the bat, we didn't have everything we have now. And then Dave Moyle, the county commissioner here, I told him what the issue was, and he offered us to stay at the dojo. The whole coaching aspect was a big surprise for me. Four of my guys that I trained went to go fight, and all of them won first round.
In the civilian world, it's easier for me to find a job than it is for him because the medical transpose is over. I can go work on an ambulance, I can go work in a hospital, I've been a medication tech, I've done just about everything. I gave it up, the medical field, for a little bit. After years of watching people die that you care about, your brain can't handle it. I'm not a waitress because I have to be. I'm a waitress because I choose to be. Feeding America really helped us because we could save that little bit of money instead of spending it on food to get a place to live or to get a car. That food actually took us a long way. It got us where we needed to go. We just needed that little push, you know, that little bit of help that we could get.
It got us through a month and a half of where we wouldn't have food because we were going through a rough patch.
It was hard for us. I'm not really supposed to be working right now because of my injury. But I do. I can't just not work. I want to go to college, and I want to be a biomedical engineer. It'll be nice now that we're on our feet. We have a base to go from.